A once-in-a-generation review into the Reserve Bank has been announced as it comes under fire for its repeated forecasts that rates would not rise this year. Borrowers now facing mortgage repayments soaring by more than $1,000 a month by Christmas.
The spotlight is shining brightly on the Reserve Bank.
We expect further increases will be required in the cash rate over the months ahead.
As the central bank's governor defends previous statements on interest rates that proved so profoundly wrong.
It is still plausible that the first increase in the cash rate will not be before 2024.
Advice that would have guided borrowers booking massive loans in last year's red-hot property market.
The latest data and forecasts do not warrant an increase in the cash rate in 2022.
It wasn't just interest rates. Despite inflation surging around the world late last year, the governor dismissed the idea that it would become a problem here.
Wages are only growing at 2.5%. I don't think we're going to have an inflation problem in this country.
It's a very different story now.
Inflation rate to the March quarter was 5.1%.
Inflation will now soar above 7% and rates will rise steeply as the central bank tries to curb it.
ANZ's come out and said 3.35% by the end of this year.
If the official cash rate hits 3.35% by December, then average variable loans will top 6%, pushing monthly repayment costs on recent Sydney median home loans up by more than $2,000.
These interest rate rises will sting because every dollar that a household spends on servicing their mortgage is a dollar that they can't spend meeting some of the other skyrocketing costs of essentials.
Today, the Treasurer announced the first review of the Reserve Bank in 40 years, saying it wasn't a response to forecasting errors.
This is not about revolutionising monetary policy in Australia. It's about reviewing it and then refining it and reforming it.
We have seen forecasting errors, guidance errors from the Reserve Bank in recent times, and the review does need to look at those things.
The review will report in March. Chris Yorman, Nine News.